And now for today's Bible question. Today we learned how Jesus exposed the hypocrisy of the Pharisees who had set aside the words of God in order to keep their own traditions. We also saw how Jesus answered the pleas of a desperate woman because of her persistent and humble faith. We learned how Jesus miraculously restored the hearing and speech of a man, and how all marveled and said that he did all things well. Someone might ask the question, why are some people born blind, deaf, or with some other defect? It would seem that if God was loving to all his creatures, and his creation was very good, that all creatures should not have to suffer with crippling diseases or defects to their body, while others enjoy a healthy body. It seems cruel that some have to suffer such horrible afflictions to their bodies. We might think it unfair to see someone blind who has to beg on the roadside, or someone with useless limbs who cannot work. Perhaps you know someone or have a relative that is incapacitated by some terrible defect to their bodies, and you know firsthand how they suffer and how much others have to do for them. Does it seem God has forgotten these poor souls? Not at all. Notice when Jesus walked in this world, those who came to him were the poor, the desperate, the crippled. They, above all others, cried out to Jesus because they desperately sensed their need for healing. Jesus was always ready and willing to help and heal those who came to him. He felt their pain and he knew their struggles. Of course, God never intended man to suffer with broken and defective bodies. He made Adam and Eve perfect and wanted them to enjoy fellowship with him forever. When sin entered the world through disobedience, a curse came upon all of creation. The curse has affected everything from all animal and plant life to the stability of the earth and climate. God's creation was perfect, but sin brought defects into the creation. That is why we can contract diseases like malaria, why vicious storms destroy land and homes. It is why earthquakes, volcanoes happen, and why wild animals attack and kill. It is also why some people are born blind, lame, or deaf. The curse upon creation has affected everything, and although traces of God's original beauty and glory designed into creation are still evident, so much has been destroyed because of sin. We are in a decaying and dying world that is under the judgment of God. We are all suffering the consequences of sin upon the creation, and each visit to the hospital or the graveside reminds us of this. You might ask then, why does God not just heal everyone and remove the effects of the curse from this world, so we can live happy and prosperous lives? God does not want us to live happy and prosperous while the problem of sin has not been addressed in us. As sinners, we are all responsible for the curse that God has brought upon the earth. We must confess our sin and responsibility, recognizing the terrible consequences it has not only in our lives, but in everything and everyone around us. Then we will have come to the place of true repentance. The only answer to the devastating effects of sin is to be found in Jesus. Jesus was the perfect man and sinless, not subject to the curse or corruption. But he came to this cursed world and actually became a curse for us. All the curse against creation and against man was transferred to Jesus when he hung upon the cross. That is why he is able to heal, and why he is able to save your soul. Don't be angry with God when people suffer. Be angry about your sin. Repent and trust in Jesus as your Savior. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who hangs on a tree. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13.